Stocks and bonds are two of the most popular investments nowadays, aside from real estate. Financial experts and investors have their own opinions about which investment works best for certain types of investors. When it comes to stability, in addition to a diversified portfolio, a bond is considered a conservative and safe investment. This is because a bond refers to a type of investment that's usually issued by corporations and governments in order to raise money to capitalize their projects in exchange for agreed fixed payments. Hey guys, this is Simran from ClearTax, and today I'll be talking about 4 mistakes to avoid while investing in bonds along with their solutions. But before we begin, do not forget to press the bell icon and like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more updates. So let's begin. The first one is unaware of bond trading levels. Many investors do not perform in-depth research before buying bonds. What they don't know is that all bond transactions in the country are reported to the concerned authority, which they can use to their advantage. If only investors know that the most important information they need to obtain from the bond issuers is the International Securities Identification Number, also known as ISIN, which is a 12-digit alphanumeric code. Once the code is entered, investors will obtain data of the bond's trading history. In India, the task of issuing ISIN for various securities has been assigned by the Securities and Exchange Board of India, also known as SEBI, to the National Securities Depository Limited, also known as the NSDL. For the government securities, the allotment of the ISIN code is regulated by the Reserve Bank of India. It's important to be aware of the price levels of bonds being offered by corporations and governments by knowing their trading history. Otherwise, you'll miss grabbing the best bond investing opportunities. Knowing the bond trading levels will help you determine if a bond level is fair or is only being exploited by the dealer. You can even buy bonds that are too cheap but worth it with thorough research. The second one is too concerned about increasing rates. A lot of investors tend to set their own perception of too low and too high rates. A valid investment portfolio involves allocation of capital to equities that are unappealing in a fixed income. Some investors are also reluctant to purchase bonds because they are afraid that their portfolio price will decline. Don't be too concerned about increasing rates. The bond market has proven to always have an upward slope. As compared to investing in stocks, bonds have less price volatility because of more predictable cash flows. The third one is getting extra yield. Nowadays, it's hard to get excited about extra yields. Still, many investors want to earn extra yields, such as buying longer dated maturities and buying lower rated debts. These bond investment practices involve huge risks. Before even thinking of hunting yields, keep in mind that markets tend to beat up investors when they least expect it. The fourth one is profit margin misunderstanding. Because the bond market is usually played by institutional investors, small-sized dealers don't really bother large institutional dealers. Small retailers, commercial retailers, wholesalers, and manufacturers have needs in varying levels to earn. While manufacturers offer a cheap price, small retailers sell for a relatively higher price. The same approach applies to bond investing. The more hands involved in the process, the higher the price will be. First, purchase bonds when they are first issued. Buying bonds with different prices would mean sacrificing your yield because of the markups. Second, buy bonds with a reasonable maturity date within 10 years. Third, buy bonds from high quality issuers such as corporations, municipalities, and governments. And fourth, hire an investment advisor with excellent institutional experience to help you in handling the complexities and challenges associated with bond investing. Many investors make the same mistakes when investing in bonds, such as hunting extra yields, which is too risky. Also, a lot of investors don't study the bond market well, are unaware of the pricing levels, and are reluctant in buying more bonds. Don't be afraid to invest in bonds because this investment is more predictable than stocks. A well-diversified investment portfolio should have a good dispersion of maturities in order to attain a steady annual cash flow. Well, this was it for today's video. Let us know what you think about the video and comment below if you have any doubts. We will try to reply to it as soon as we can. Stay tuned to our channel for more informative videos like these. Till then, goodbye and take care.